What's up, Power Ranger fans? This is John, host of Video Games in the World. So, yesterday, it was announced that Hasbro has acquired the rights to Power Rangers from Saban Brands. Not only Power Rangers, but several other brands from Saban were purchased by Hasbro, including My Pet Monster, Popples, Julius Jr., Luna Petunia, Treehouse Detectives, and more. The deal, which includes cash and stock, is valued at $522 million. Wow. Power Rangers has been an iconic franchise for 25 long years, spawning toys, video games, comics, school utilities, 3 full feature films, and tons of other merchandise. However, this is not the first time that Saban had sold the Power Rangers. In 2001, Saban sold the series to Disney. Under Disney, we've had Power Rangers shows like Wild Force, Ninja Storm, Dino Thunder, Space Patrol Delta, Mystic Force, Operation Overdrive, Jungle Fury, and RPM. Saban then bought the franchise again, and under it we've had Samurai Super Samurai, Mega Force, Super Mega Force, Dino Charge, Super Dino Charge, Ninja Steel, and currently Super Ninja Steel. The upcoming Power Rangers show will be Beast Morphers, which is an adaptation of Tokumei Sentai Go Busters. Haim Saban stated the following: 25 years after launching Power Rangers, I believe the future for this brand has never been greater. Hasbro's leadership in innovation, storytelling, and brand stewardship make it the perfect company to further develop the global reach and appeal of the Power Rangers property. I look forward to working with Brian and the team in the years to come. Many fans will start seeing products from Hasbro in 2019, and I wonder that Power Rangers is now acquired by Hasbro. Will they have a crossover with the Transformers? Maybe they will, or maybe not. Hey, there could be a chance though, since we saw a crossover of Power Rangers and Justice League, but we all know Justice League is DC Comics, not Hasbro. Although some fans would have loved to see Power Rangers team up with the Avengers instead. Brian Goldner, CEO of Hasbro, has also stated, "Power Rangers is an iconic brand built on a heritage of great storytelling and merchandising with tremendous upside potential when fully executed across Hasbro's brand blueprint. Shortly after entering into our licensing agreement, it became clear that now was the time to begin investing in unlocking Power Rangers' full potential. We see significant opportunity for Power Rangers across our entire brand blueprint, including toys and games, consumer products, digital gaming and entertainment, as well as geographically throughout our global retail footprint. We couldn't be more pleased that Haim Saban will continue in a consulting role to further guide our development of this valuable property for the next generation of Power Rangers fans." So what do you think? Is it good that Hasbro owns the Power Rangers? Will they do good or bad? Leave your comments, rate, and subscribe. This is John, host of Video Games and the World. Have a good one. Bye-bye.